At the end of this online module, you should be able to use built-in functions to perform algebraic and trigonometric calculations. We are going to look at two different problems to understand these learning objectives. Let's look at a problem that will help us better understand these concepts. Your engineering firm works on ensuring the safe use of fire station equipment. For safety, an extension ladder used in firefighting must be placed against a wall so that it makes an angle of no more than 75 degrees with the ground. Every ladder needs a safety sticker stating the maximum distance from the wall. If a ladder is 20 feet long, we need to determine what distance the sticker must indicate. Let's try and visualize what this problem is asking first. We know that the ladder is 20 feet long and that the angle it makes with the ground is 75 degrees. We can assume that the building we are leaning the ladder against makes a 90 degree angle with the ground. This gives us a right angle triangle with a hypotenuse of 20 feet long. The length we are asked to find is the distance d shown in the image here. We know the cosine of the angle 75 degrees is adjacent over hypotenuse. This gives us d as being equal to the cosine of 75 degrees multiplied by the length of the hypotenuse. The answer we obtain is 5.18 feet. We can now try our calculation in MATLAB. The computation we want to perform is to take the cosine of the angle 75 degrees and multiply that by the hypotenuse 20 feet to obtain the distance of the ladder from the wall. Let's type this out in MATLAB. Cosine of 75 times 20. Notice I use parentheses around the input argument to the function. I'll push enter. Cosine is not a function MATLAB knows, but a suggestion is being made. So let's try and figure out what our cosine is. So we know how to do this now. We'll type help followed by our function our cosine. After we push enter, we get some information here on our function our cosine. They're first recommending a more improved function to use instead of our cosine, but let's see what our cosine does. Okay, so it looks like it's a filter, and we definitely know that we are not looking for any filtering in this question. We are just trying to figure out how to take the cosine of an angle 75 degrees, so let's go back and try and see how we can do this. Let's just see if I could type this differently. So now I have cos 75 times 20, but the C in my cos is capitalized. I'll push enter. Oh, MATLAB is case sensitive. Most built-in functions are in lowercase. So let's use the suggestion that MATLAB is giving us. Cos 75 times 20. I'll push enter. Well, this still isn't the number we're expecting. Maybe I'm not using cosine correctly. So let's get some help. So I'll type that out. Oh, it looks like cos requires an argument, an input, in radians. So let's try converting from degrees to radians. So we have cos of 75 times pi over 180. We'll close the parentheses and multiply that by 20. I'll push enter, and that gives me an expected value. I also see from help that there is a cos d. When I get help with that, I see that it takes degrees. So let's try that too. Cos d 75 times 20. This gives us the right answer too. If I read the rest of the help for cos d, there's a mention there about cos n times pi over 2 not giving a value 0. Really? Let's try that. Cos pi over 2. Push enter. Wow, that really is not zero. This happens because pi is not really pi. It's a number very close, but not exactly pi, because of how it has to be represented by the computer. As a result, some error is introduced. In some computational situations, this could result in a significant error. This is not an issue that is unique to MATLAB. All computational software cannot represent pi exactly. Try it out in Excel to see. So now we're in the Excel interface, and we'll begin by typing out cosine pi over 2. And when we push enter, we see that this value, once again, is not zero. Let's look at another type of problem. Loudness is measured in decibels. The loudness of a sound is given by dB and is equal to 10 multiplied by log to the base 10 of the quantity I divided by I naught, where I naught is the intensity of threshold sound, or sound that can barely be perceived. Other sounds are defined in terms of how many times more intense they are than threshold sound. I naught is 1 times 10 to the negative 12 watts per meter squared. Prolonged exposure to sounds above 85 decibels can cause hearing damage or loss. If the sound intensity of a lawnmower is 1.25 times 10 to the negative 3 watts per meter squared, should one wear ear protection when mowing the lawn? Let's try out our calculation in a calculator to make sure we know what answer to expect. Remember that it is a good engineering habit of mind to make sure that the tools we are using work as we expect them to. Remember that this is log base 10, so you will notice this now in the equations we have typed out. The loudness of the sound is equal to 10 multiplied by the log to the base 10 of the quantity 1.25 times 10 to the power minus 3 divided by 1 times 10 to the power minus 12. The first operation that is performed is the one in parentheses, giving us the answer 1.25 times 10 to the power 9. The next operation is log to the base 10 of the answer in parentheses, giving us 9.0969. Our final answer is approximately 91 decibels. This loudness level is greater than 85 decibels, so ear protection should be worn when using the lawnmower. Let's try this out in MATLAB. I'll start by typing the equation in. So we have 10 times log, open parentheses, 1.25, e to the minus 3 over 1, e to the minus 12, and let's close these parentheses. Here I use the e notation, which is used to represent scientific notation. Let's push enter. The result is more than double what I expected. Maybe I'm not using the correct log function. So let's check the help for log. Type this out. Oh, the log function is for natural log. On the see also list, I see a function called log 10. Let's check that out. Ah, that's base 10. Let's try using that. And that gives the answer I was expecting. Let's go over a brief summary of what we learned in this module. We have to verify that the built-in function we select is appropriate for the task. We have to remember that MATLAB is case-sensitive. We have to verify the input argument requirements for the functions. For example, you need to ensure the units of the input arguments match what the function is expecting. When using a built-in function, we have to place all the input arguments in parentheses immediately following the function name. And finally, we have to be aware of potential limitations of a given function. Use the help command to learn about the different functions.